Unreal Engine or Unigine? Which engine should you use as an environmental artist? In this video, we will discuss everything you need to know to decide which one is for you. To make a sound decision, it's essential we briefly talk about their design features, learning curves, and their communities. So let's start with the design features. First and foremost, let's talk about the process of putting together a composition. Placing assets is generally the same in both engines. You can move them around, rotate and scale objects as you please, or by snapping to the grid, which makes it easy to use modular assets. The biggest distinction between the two is what units they use. Unreal uses centimeters, while Unigine uses meters. I kind of prefer meters, because outside environments are usually large, but there is no actual difference if you're not following the grid. As well, what I love at Unigine is that they use double precision coordinates, which enables you to build massive worlds, like insanely big. This can be very useful if you want to build a solar system environment. For nature environments, landscapes are crucial. In both engines, you can hand sculpt landscapes and use pre-made height maps, as well as non-destructive techniques to shape them. The major difference between the two is the way foliage is placed. In Unreal, you can simply use the foliage tool to paint meshes and even classes on the landscape or other objects. This makes it very convenient to quickly add or remove trees, grass, and other small details from the environment, you name it. On the other hand, Unigine uses clutters. These essentially represent areas where trees or other meshes should spawn. That is similar to UE4's procedural foliage, but I wish there was also a tool for finer placement. In contrast to that, Unigine has in-engine real-world terrain generation, which is very neat. What about the upper side of the environment, such as the atmosphere, clouds, and fog? To me, the clouds in UE4 always feel fake, but Unigine takes that to the next level by implementing texture-based and volumetric clouds that look absolutely fantastic. Just tell me that these don't look insanely good. Volumetric clouds are to appear out of the box in the next release of Unreal Engine, so we will have to wait until then to see exactly how good those are going to look. Besides that, both implement physically based atmospheres and true volumetric fog, so there's not much of a difference between those two. Secondly, let's go over texturing and particles. Texturing in Unigine is simple. All you have to do is import the textures, which is as simple as dragging the files in the engine and then plugging them in their slots. In Unreal, the same principle is applied, but it lets you easily go further than that with other cool effects such as panning or tiling by forcing you to create a material and using their powerful material graph. In Unigine, to create a custom material, you will have to write GLSL, HLSL, or their own language, UUSL. This can be a problem if you don't have previous coding experience, so you may prefer the visual style. UE4 has two main methods of creating particles: the easy module-based cascade system or the harder Niagara. Niagara is similar to cascade, but it also enables artists to add further functionality without the help of a programmer. Unigine's implementation is basically a slightly stripped-down cascade without modules. This isn't a bad thing, as cascade is extremely easy to use, but it has its limitations. Lastly, lighting and post-processing are ultimately what make a scene look photorealistic. Generally speaking, both engines excel in this category with very little difference in the final result. Both engines offer a lot of flexibility with the lighting and post-processing, such as choosing between baked or dynamic lighting, if they should be ray traced or not, what kind of color grading the scene should have, and so much more. All of these make it very easy to achieve different moods and styles. Not much more I can say here, besides boy I wish real life would look this good. Now we know that both engines can essentially produce the same end result because of how similar they are. Let's talk of the learning curve. Which engine is harder to learn for environmental design? I'm going to talk from my experience, so take this with a grain of salt. For me, Unigine felt considerably harder to learn than Unreal Engine. Personally, I found its UI cluttered at first, and even now it is quite hard to navigate through. Unigine also gives you a lot of control over what you create, but this comes with the downside that you need to do a lot of manual work, such as adding live shafts by hand. And this can take quite a lot of time in the long run. What's also very important to consider is the documentation. Fortunately, both engines have a bunch of videos for any major feature that you are going to use. And if there is not a video, there surely is a text version. What I especially like at Unigine's documentation is how simple and clear their explanations are. The last major factor that should influence your decision is the community. Having a dedicated community can come in handy to learn specific things. After being in the Unreal community for so long, I can confidently say that it is a great source of help. From my research on Unigine's forum, questions frequently get answered by both the community and their team, which is good to see. What you should also consider is the benefits of being in one or the other. For example, the Unreal community has free access to the Megascans library, which can be extremely helpful. These alone might be the reasons you choose one or the other. Now back to the question, Unreal or Unigine? Which one should you use? Frankly, use the one that fits your needs the best. Either is a great game engine that can deliver astonishing environments, so there is no right or wrong choice in this case, especially because they are so similar. What I recommend is trying out both and deciding based on your experience and which one felt easier for you. And that's everything for today. If you enjoyed this comparison video, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with other videos. And make sure to let me know in the comments, which engine do you think is the best for you? Can't wait to hear what your answers are. I want to thank everyone over on Patreon for their support, and especially to these folks: Avirama FM, Badr Al-Kakhtani, Giovanni Pena, Golden Glowmaster, Leonardo Pereira, and Realitats Verlost. Now make sure to go and watch this video right here. Thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next video.